Hello and welcome back to Boring Dad Gaming, where today we're going to be playing some more Dave the Diver. Did a lot of upgrade in the end of the last episode. We're looking pretty good now in our... Actually, let's just recap what we've got now, just to remind ourselves. So we've got up to level 4 air, level 3 depth, we're doing pretty well at that. Level 5 carrying though, we're up to 42 kilograms now, which is pretty cool. Still only on the level 2 harpoon though. But yeah, basically we're going to be able to breathe a lot longer, go down a bit deeper, and carry a lot more. In terms of our quest, we've got to go to the rock pile again, if we can remember where that is, and we're looking for some blue and brown shells for Ellie. Also bought a couple of things from Cobra's shop. We got a 10%... Is it 10% or a flat 10 increase to our oxygen? I can't remember. And we've also got like a 50% refill at some point if we need it, so that's pretty good. I'm not sure what this is. This is one of our things? This is a brown seashell. Okay. We'll grab the stuff as we see it. Something else down there. Check what's in here. Got a Japanese sword, that's pretty cool. Another brown seashell. This is like a blue one. I've got a gun chest here. Shock harpoon, I'll take that. It's another shell type over here, the blue one. Oh, another brown one there. How are we doing? One more blue shell. I think there was one in here. Is that it? No, that's a silver bowl. We've got so much carry capacity now. Let's actually take some copper. Shell. We need a blue one though. I think there was one off around this way. Can we get up here? Here we go, and there was a flavor pod as well, I think. I wonder if we can get... You're supposed to be able to catch morays. I wonder if we can do that with this guy. Oh, he's completely vanished there. Are we doing anything to... Oh, hello. Using all my ammo on this guy. I've seen him on the menu though. Like, I feel like we should be able to catch a moray. I just don't quite know how. Right, let's go get it now. Ow! Alright, we'll grab some lumber. So we've got Ellie's stuff. We could go back to the rock pile, I suppose. Oh yeah, we'll get some more ammo, because we used quite a lot on that moray. I've actually got one of these, so let's use what we've got now. Then I'll take this one. So what happens with this? I'm on 178, 195, wow, okay. So yeah, increases our capacity, which is good. We've got quite a lot of air now. I think we've already got that, but is that the same thing we've got? I think it is. Let's keep going deeper. Oh, did I not get my ammo? I thought I got more ammo. Did I miss it? I might have missed it. I thought there was an ammo box around here. Alright, bugger off. Did I not see an ammo box? I don't know why I went so high pitched there. There we go. Okay, we've got a full ammo now. I think I might take on that big fish, this thing, because this has been the bane of my life for a little while now. Put some more ammo there for it. Alright, let's get some more ammo. takes a beating, this, doesn't it? I think we got it. No idea what this is. Is it a sailfish? It's a long-nosed saw shark. Okay. Grab some of that. Now, what's this little thing? I don't think I've seen this before. Oh, I didn't get it. Clown frogfish, that's new. Okay, so let's try and find this rock wall then. I think we've actually got the blueprint for that, so I'm not going to make another one. This mackerel are worth quite a lot of money though. Oh, it's a trevally. I thought that was a mackerel. Or trevally. Trevally? I don't even know how you say it. Turmeric. We've got quite a lot of capacity now. Red mullet or something? Oh, I got inked. Oh, let's go for this guy. Coral trout. I think that's a new one. Some more oxygen at some point. What's this thing? Got a skull. Ah, there we go. That's our other net gun blueprint. I think we could be able to make that now. I'm not very good at mashing these keys with my left hand. So I'm not sure I like the shock one for that reason. Oh, we're going to get inked again. There's O2. Good. I think these take us up to full. They do. Oh, another gun box over here. Oh, what's this? The Red Angel of War penetrates targets marked with its laser sight lies here. So what's that? Oh, it's like a sniper rifle, I think. We'll take that for now. It seems pretty good. I mean, I wonder how many blueprints we'll need to actually make it, but... Oh yeah, I like being able to carry more stuff. It just feels a lot less restrictive. Probably going to be some current here, I thought so. No, you don't. Could get another angelfish. Should we try it with the sniper rifle? Did I say angelfish? I meant anglerfish, whatever I said. That's what I mean. Oh, was that like a tennis racket? Alright, well it does more damage and has knockback, so we'll take that. Take some more ammo. I like the sniper rifle.
We're here! Try placing one of the bombs Cobra gave you onto that rock pile!
Let me grab some more of this stuff, though. I don't remember where we got the bomb, but I think we just do this.
All good? You know, it's sort of hard to see through the radio. We can't have you torn into 1,000 pieces and become food for the sharks.
Oh, that's a scary thing to say, such a casual voice.
Now back away from the bomb for a bit.
Don't have to tell me twice.
Here, that should be enough. Here it goes! Nice, now the road is clear! There's a faint light coming from inside. Go on inside!
What if there's a monster or something inside?
That would also be an amazing scientific discovery.
So let's quickly bring up this, because we're supposed to have a camera as well. I don't know how to use it. Is the only thing. Maybe we'll get told. Go to new region, sure.
Sea People Record Chamber. Wow, this place is. It appears to be some kind of Sea People Record Chamber. My lucky feeling was correct. There definitely was a Sea People civilization in this region. Look at the mural back there. No human could have painted that so deep underwater.
Maybe these are from some ancient civilization that sank from seismic activity.
A good point, but that style of painting and architecture can't be seen anywhere above ground. Please, first investigate this place. I'm sure you'll be able to find a variety of interesting clues.
Okay, the oxygen seems to be staying static. This can't be a natural pillar. There are even mysterious characters engraved in it. Okay. This mural seems to be of a warrior or a king. It looks powerful. There seem to be scales on the lower body. Is this really a mural of the Sea People? What's this thing? Is this something I can interact with? Doesn't seem like it. What's this? Is there something I can pick up? A painting of dolphins and marine plants. Apparently the Sea People could draw, not only write.
Good, that should be enough. I would like to research a little more, so please take a photo with the camera I gave you.
How do we do that? Oh, okay. Maybe we just go to that point. Camera icon indicates you can take pictures. Check your objective on the top left. Use space to adjust the focus and remove your hand to take a picture. Make sure your timing matches the green indicators. Okay. Little mini game thing then. Hold focus. There we go. Oh, fail. Restart. Success. Okay, I don't think I was that far off the first time. Okay.
Ooh, I see something on the floor there.
Oh, it might be another Sea People artifact. Bring it to me.
Okay, we can do that. I like that the oxygen's not going down in this area.
Is the sound from before?
The record chamber filled with Sea People symbols. What could they have written?
More importantly, didn't you hear something?
What do you mean? I didn't hear anything over the radio. Come back up to the boat for now.
I can actually sprint round here because it doesn't drop my air down at all.
Go back.
Okay, so we're going to be dropping down oxygen again now. We've still got a bit of capacity. Oh, I would quite like to catch a pufferfish. I wonder if I could snipe it when it... Just hurry, puffer. Now these guys... Oh, hang on. No, let's go back to... Are these the mackerels? I'll catch this one then.
Come on. Ow! Ah.
Right, have some of that. Atlantic mackerel, yeah. We're actually overweight now. Okay. Let's head back up. Got quite a lot of air. Might actually catch another one. Ah, get away from me. Oh. No. Is he gonna come back? He might do. Oh, come on, that was in the green. There we go. All right, better go back up. If we see an emergency out, we'll take it. Oh dear, shark. There we go. Hopefully I can get this before the shark sees me. We go. Not bad morning. A sea people artifact. Oh, very interesting. Well, I'm glad you like it. I'll have to analyze this artifact in the mural further at my lab. I'll be in touch soon. Who's this? Oh dear.
Hey, you there. I heard an explosion in the sea. Do you know what's going on?
Oh, about that.
We are Sea Blue. We're an organization that tracks down people who pollute this beautiful sea and reports them. I sometimes carry out justice myself for those that commit particularly evil deeds. I've had reports of someone who's been engaging in mindless destruction of the environment in these parts. I don't know if it was you, but you better be aware of this. Whoever harms the great sea will have to contend with Sea Blue. And me, John Watson. Now then, be ever grateful to the sea and never lose your love for it. I'll be leaving for now. We're watching you.
The pixel art's great, isn't it? What a creepy dude. Will we be okay?
Sea Blue. Oh, that group is infamous. They commit acts of violence under the pretext of environmental protection. It's mostly the large corporations with big fishing businesses. And not the small fisheries that harm the environment most. They say nothing to the corporations, however. I expect they're taking bribes or something unsavoury like that.
Well, that guy looked like bad news.
It won't do you any good to be on their radar. Be careful.
Already?
Phew, that was harder than I expected. These are hard to find.
Well, this isn't bad. Now then, if I could just complete the delivery to EcoWatcher. Ta-da! Ha-ha! Research level gained.
Huh? EcoWatcher?
Oh, you don't know? EcoWatcher is a mission-based app made to protect the environment. You get points for completing missions on the app, and get rewards for reaching certain levels.
So this was for points on the app, not for the paper.
Well, you could say they're basically the same thing. So you try it out too if you're interested. See ya!
Okay, we're done that. Got EcoWatcher now.
Use the EcoWatcher app to check on various ecological missions. Gather points to receive various rewards. Cool.
Got the small net gun, started on our red sniper rifle, which I liked a lot. That looks pretty good, doesn't it? I guess we go back down. So this one. Crafting weapons. Silver dishes for selling. Doesn't really say what those are for. Sell a silver bowl, I suppose. I don't think these shells are needed. We'll sell those. They seem quite plentiful anyway. I'll sell the spines. Okay, we could go on the gun app and see if we can upgrade anything, maybe. We don't need to make another basic underwater rifle, do we? More rope and scrap iron for the net gun. Targets caught will be of high grade. Capture 7 fish at the same time. Interesting. Normal fish tranquilize after 8 seconds. Oh, we actually need the starfish for this. I tend to find quite a lot of these. We can try and get some more scrap iron and stuff, though. Let's have a look at Eco Watcher. Analyzing the food of the blue starfish will help in the ecological study of the blue hole. So what do you do? Do we just catch those, then? Oh man, I've just sold a bunch of these. And animal foot bone, animal leg bone. We capture 5 Friday jellyfish and red lionfish. So okay, let's have a look at the rewards then. An eco health bracelet for level 1. Okay. We actually can equip bracelets, can't we? I think it's on our equipment screen. I can't remember what is this our equipment screen? It's probably a charm, isn't it? So let's have a think. What might we do then for a mission here that's easy to do? Maybe the starfish or the pink shells? We need 50. Agar's really easy as well. Okay. Cool. Lots to think about. Lots to do. We've kind of done our big missions for the day. So maybe we'll try some of these eco missions now. So we can try and do the agar, the starfish, and any pink shells we see. Is this a pink shell? It's a brown seashell. Take that, though. I don't know how we're going to catch this moray. Well, I mean, we might need to catch other colour shells, mightn't we? So I guess we could still take this stuff. Okay, so we'll go down here. There's a red starfish. Take that. Get some more components. I'll take some more copper. We've probably got agar. We want some of that, don't we? We'll take those. Oh, yeah, useful. We'll have that. Got a weapon box here. We'll check that out. Oh, okay. Yeah, flame tip. Okay. Don't think we found any pink shells yet. Let's go a bit deeper. I don't really want to hush. I don't know if there's much in here. There's mo too. Oh, what's this? Oh, it was a clam that kind of does your O2. Fair enough. Try and get the anglerfish again. Hey. I don't know if there's much actually down further this way. Well, that looks like a pink one. That's another O2 shell, but we can save that. There's quite a lot of these guys. Whoa, that was a red one. Oh, there's more bones there. We want those. No! I don't feel like I was in that current. Oh, the skull. We wanted a different type of bone, really. Ooh. Come on, let me go. Let's actually shoot this one. Loads of weight capacity still. Is that a pink one or a brown one? I think it's a brown one. But... Oh. Something down here. What's that? Tranquilizer harpoon tip. Alright, we'll give that a go. What's this? Oh, there's a biggie. Hello. Might come back for him later. Oops. Are we sleeping? What are you saying? I don't know what that was. Looked like he wanted some kind of vehicle to transport the fish. How do we catch this one? There we go. Is it a tuna? Giant trevally meat. Oh, okay. Get a couple of these then. Sweet. I've got some scrap iron and stuff down here and glass. Oh, another pink shell. That's good. Oh, and another one. I think we wanted three, didn't we? Well, let's try and capture this before that big shark sees us. Oh, another skull. I don't think I'm equipped to fight that shark yet. Maybe if I had the sniper rifle or something. So there's a silver bowl here. This looks about as deep as we can go. In this area, anyway. catch this one now? Yes. Okay, so is the bigger one needed some kind of special transport? Interestingly. Okay, I'm a little concerned about the air, I'm not gonna lie. I do have... I mean, I can give myself... Okay, so we got an evac here. I've got a canister in my inventory. We can check this out, though. This was the thing that the squid sank, wasn't it? What's that? Lightning harpoon tip. No, I'll keep the trank one, actually. It's interesting, because these smaller ones might... I think we can, let's just press C, let's just stay down here a bit longer. So I can't do a lot with this boat, I don't think. So we'll just have a little bit more of an explore. Not worth trying to get over there. I think I've been here, that's the flaming tip I dropped, wasn't it? Been here. Kind of getting more towards the currents again, aren't we? No. Not get out of there. Let's get out of here. There's more of the gun part. Instant sleep. Okay, we're getting a bit heavy now. What was that, a flask? That's level 3. I guess I'm not sure if the other one was level 3. It probably was. Okay, we're heavy now, and we can evac if we want. Oh, this is like a new type of metal. Let's take this with this. Iron ore. Okay. Oh, yellow starfish ingredient. Let's try for these. Let's take the wood as well. Hey, small sock sauce. Okay, well, I think we head back. We're overweight. Oxygen is getting a little low. Got quite a lot of stuff. I don't think we did any of the full eco missions, but I think it's probably something you... wait, is that up here? Probably something that you do over multiple dives, maybe? There's some stuff here, actually. Maybe I should take this first. Is this anything? Oh, this isn't anything. All right, let's get out. Down to our deepest depth so far, 129, not bad. So let's have a... Oh, okay. Oh, cooking! Look at that cooking! Oh, they're going to be expensive though, aren't they? And this guy's rubbish at cooking. Oh, he's going to be even more expensive than the other guy. We've got no money. I just wanted to check the eco stuff, how we did. So we need quite a lot more yellow starfish. We did actually do the pink shell, so we can deliver that one. Yes. Doing quite well. Well, I'm doing well on the skulls. reset shell 2. Okay, yeah, we've been collecting that other stuff, so that's not too bad. Alright, yeah, made a bit of progress on that. Weapon shop, we done something here? Was it the net gun? Might be the net gun. We can try making the net gun. I can skip the set. We've seen that one a few times before. Small net gun. Okay. I guess we could make this one, couldn't we? Oh, this is a different one. What's going on there? Okay. Well, we got those networks. We made it. We made everything that we can. Yeah, fair enough. Is there some, I think these are just saying I can deliver. I suppose we could deliver these just so I don't accidentally sell it. Right, let's see if we can sell anything to Cobra. We're not going to make enough money to hire that. Hello? Oh, is the shop closed for the day? Oh, never mind. Okay, well, we're definitely not going to be able to hire probably either of those guys. Which is a shame. I mean, I'm glad I got the suit upgrades I did, but we're at the stage now where we really need, like, a second cook in the kitchen, and unfortunately, we've got a really good one today. Look at these guys. VIP, Vincent the Gourmet. Hello viewers, this is Yui from the TV show Star the Chef. Today I've come to a seaside sushi bar that's all the rage on Cookster, Bancho Sushi. In this sushi bar that's famous for its exotic sushi, we have with us the legendary sushi expert, Vincent Yamaoka.
I am Vincent Yamaoka.
Hello Vincent, how would you define sushi?
Sushi is a very simple dish. There's only rice, vinegar, wasabi, and the fish that goes on top. Everything hangs upon these ingredients. However, simple does not mean easy. Listen. How good the ingredients are, how they were stored and aged, how they were cut, how the rice was cooked, and how it was molded. All those things matter in the art of sushi. Yes.
I see. In that case, what do you think the exotic sushi that Bancho is sushi is famous for?
The ingredients for sushi have long been similar. The king of fish, the tuna, particularly the belly. Below that, the olive flounder and amberjack with white and red meat. All verified ingredients, you understand. To dare to use new ingredients despite the many proven ones that existed from the Edo era. Regardless of the taste, this shows a lack of respect.
You have once criticized California rolls as not being real sushi. Be curious to see what your opinion on Bancho sushi will be. Now then, let's start by introducing the star of today's show. This is the owner, Bancho.
This is a bit sudden. I'm called Ban...
He's quite reticent. That can only mean he speaks through his cooking. This sushi bar offers a fantastic view as it's near the giant blue hole, and the chef sure gives off the vibes of a master. I'm really looking forward to how the food will taste. Vincent, which food will you be trying?
I'm not really interested in the food of a place that's so focused on appearances. You there, Bancho, was it? Your name? Let me take a look at what you can do. Let me see. Bring me something to surprise me.
Wow, Vincent offers such a daring provocation. He left the menu for the chef to decide.
I can't just sit by and listen to your prejudiced thinking. Give me 2 days. I'll be sure to shock you.
A standoff between a traditional gourmet and an exotic chef. Things are getting real interesting. We'll come to you live on the next episode. Don't forget to tune in next time to Star the Chef.
What are you thinking? What are you going to do?
A man does not run from a challenge. I've thought of something. Will you get me the ingredients? I need some sea grape and white spotted jellyfish.
I think I've already got those.
They can both be harvested in the limestone cave about 100 meters down in the depths. By the way, you'll need to capture the wide-spotted jellyfish alive. You'll need a tranquilizer gun or a net gun.
Okay, well, I've got the net gun now. You're going to make sushi with those? Okay, a limestone cave rod. I'll go look for them. Yeah, well, we can do that. That's fine. Sometimes a VIP customer will order a dish that's not on the menu. Right, we've actually got those things. But I didn't capture a jellyfish alive, so I probably should do that. Let's have a look at the research. Probably do this one now. I think we've seen this animation. They are fun. Look at the staff, but I think these guys are... Oh, look how much. Even this guy is not particularly good. Yeah. I really want to be able to hire him. Not today, though. Not today. I can't even afford to place another ad. Let's have a look at the menu. See, what's this? Giant trevally meat. So I can enhance this. I think that's worth doing. Thing. There we go. Got this one too, the long nose saw shark sushi. We should probably enhance that to get the most out of it. They're saying you can enhance again to level 3, but well, maybe we should. We still have quite a lot of it. Okay. The same with the giant trevally meat, maybe. Take that a bit further. Anyway, so we're going to add this to the menu. We've only got 3 of them now. Same with the long nose shark. So it's warty frogfish. Okay, that sounds lovely, doesn't it? Maybe we could enhance that too. What's this one? This is the anglerfish. Okay, we can enhance this probably. We got quite a lot of it. We could do it again. So stick that on the menu. Hang on. Coral trout, maybe? Atlantic mackerel we could do. What's this one? That's the big eye trevally. I think we could probably enhance this one. Maybe a couple of times. Do this one. Okay, seems like a good menu. Oh, yeah, it didn't go well last time. We need another cook, so let's see how this goes. Green tea at the end. Let's get started on that. Okay, got another green tea. Hopefully she's alright serving these for a while. Ah, put too much in. Alright, anyone about to run out of patience yet? One at the end. The end in time, maybe. Whoa. Now you do that one.
exactly the swamp. And we're at dirty plate at the end. Gonna run out of wasabi. Is that it? Okay. Didn't do too bad. I think that was better than the previous time. Made a quite a lot of money, which is nice. Only a 4-star though, because we're running out of time. So we do need... Could do with an extra server as well. An extra chef and an extra server. Oh no. Dave.
Yes, Dr. Bacon?
Dave.
Yes.
Do you want to hear the good news or the bad news?
Well, the good news.
Ah, you're the positive type. I studied the bracelet you brought me yesterday. It was from the sea people, as I expected.
Wow, so it's an ancient artifact.
The bracelet seems to be imbued with a mysterious power. Here, you can wear this.
What, me? I mean, I'm grateful, but why?
Ah, who knows? There might be some frightening sea people curse on it. Well, in any case, try it on first.
As he cleaned it up a bit. Sea people bracelet. Survive for a certain period after running out of oxygen. Has a mysterious energy that aids breathing. Very nice.
Well, I feel some kind of new power inside me.
Ah, glad to hear nothing bad happened. You'll be able to check your diver box for more information about the charm you're wearing. Oh, and I have more great news. I've analysed the artifacts and investigation data, and I was able to find a very strong signal in these ocean depths. This was the right place. The objects didn't just float over here. I have a feeling the giant blue hole that suddenly appeared is serving as a conduit to a sea people site. A very lucky opportunity.
Well, that just sounds like I have to risk my life again. So, what's the bad news?
In order to venture deep, you'll need a deep sea headlamp. Deliveries have stopped right now for some reason, so getting one is out of the question.
Maybe Duff will have one. He's all sorts of things.
You're right. Try contacting Duff first, will ya? G'day.
Equip charms. Yep. Seems pretty standard. So we can go on the weapon shop, I guess. Don't really get what we're looking at there. I feel like we probably ought to bring this to a close, though, looking at the time on the video. So, I think we'll say... I'm going to catch jellyfish in the next one, but we'll say we'll leave it here for now. So, thanks very much for watching this episode of Dave the Diver. I hope you've enjoyed it. I'm still enjoying it a lot. There's lots more to discover, I'm sure, as well. But if you have enjoyed it, if you could hit the thumbs up button on the video, that'd be fantastic. And as well as leaving me a comment, let me know what you think about the game and everything in it. And lastly, if you're watching this and haven't already subscribed to the channel, it'd be amazing if you could do so. It'd be great to have you on board, Boring Dad Gaming. So thanks very much once again, and I hope to see you next time for more Dave the Diver. Bye for now.